Hi, in a previous video I showed how to back up your IP office system without using an SD card reader, and in this video I will be showing you how to take that information and send it back to your system. Now, the first thing you need to do is connect to your control unit, whether that be connecting directly or connecting on a Ethernet switch. In my opinion, the easiest way would be to connect it to an Ethernet switch, because when the system first boots up, by default it's going to be looking for a DHCP IP address, and as long as you have a DHCP server on your network, it will take an IP address from that server. And your computer by default is set to take a DHCP IP address as well, which means that by default both the control unit and the computer will be able to communicate. So let's take a look at how to open up the file and get your system restored. So you're going to click on File, Offline, Open File, browse to the folder where you have your file saved. You may have it on the desktop. I actually saved mine on the C drive and in a folder called Phone System Backup. Double click on your file to open it up. Click on File, Offline, Send Config. Click on the checkbox next to your control unit and click OK. Enter in the password for your control unit. The default is Administrator with a capital A. This is going to do an immediate reboot of the control unit, so immediate is already selected. If you select merge, then it's not going to work, so make sure you leave immediate selected, or if you happen to be using the system, you may want to do when free or timed. Click OK. It asks for the password again. Once your system finishes rebooting, if you have any voicemail files to restore, you can do that now. Click on File, Advanced, Embedded File Management. Click on the checkbox next to your system and log in. The login is the same as you normally would log in. Click on System SD, and then click on System, and then Dynamic, and then LVMail. Right-click on the middle pane and click on Upload, and browse to the folder where you have your voicemail file stored. Click on the first voicemail file, hold down the Shift button, press the down arrow button until they're all selected, and then click on Open. Once it finishes uploading, you can click on Close. And remember that these are all the voicemail files that your voicemail uses. This is the auto attendant greetings, the mailbox messages, names, and greetings. And then you can click on File, Configuration to get back to your regular configuration. So now you know how to restore your standard mode or basic mode IP office configuration, including the embedded voicemail files, using a LAN connection. And that's our video for today. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Twitter, and thanks for watching.